Folks, we appreciate your patience. We're going to wait just a few moments and hope the rain lets up a bit before we bring the seniors across. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Carson Carrico, and I'm a member of the graduating class of 2022. Before we begin, please take a moment to turn off or silence cell phones and any other electronic devices and refrain from using them during the Mass. Parents, family, and friends, on behalf of the Trinity faculty and staff and the class of 2022, welcome to our Baccalaureate Mass. This gathering is the culmination of a four-year journey, celebrating the unity and spirit that makes our class extraordinary and unique. We've been through unprecedented challenges, and we've had tremendous successes and growth. As our senior year ends, we look back with gratitude for the friendships and experiences that have brought us to this moment. Being together in class, in competitions on the field or court, speech and debate or FBLA, on the stage or in the hallways, in the lunch line, and on senior retreat. We also look forward to the new chapter in our lives that is about to begin. This is our last time on this campus as a class. So with our family and friends beside us, we thank God for the opportunities and gifts He has given us in our time together. We celebrate together this moment, knowing that while we will soon be going our separate ways, we will always be Trinity Brothers, the class of 2022, forever. Together we're best. Please participate by following along in the worship aid, and most especially with respect, reverence, and prayer. Please remain seated during opening procession.
Every heart, we worship you, we worship you. Please join me in the sign of our faith in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let me speak for all of us and welcome you to this Baccalaureate Mass for the graduating class of 2022. My friends, as we begin, let's take a moment to tell our God of our need for his help and for his forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you have blessed us and helped us grow over the last 4 years. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you forgive us all our sins and are always ready to renew your friendship with us. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you walk with us into our future. Lend us your strength and your spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. And so, may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins and shortcomings, and lead us to life everlasting. Amen. Let us all join now in our great hymn of praise. And so we pray. God our Father, we are reminded as we come together this evening of how much we need each other and you. Our years together at Trinity are formally over as of now. We turn to you, dear God, to ask you to come to us and help us realize the power of the brotherhood we share. Together we have shared a lot of life, and now we leave to bring our unique gifts to all those we meet. We pray that we may always know your love, walk in the friendship of Jesus your Son, and be guided by your Holy Spirit. We make our prayer as always through that same Jesus who lives with you and the Spirit, as Trinity, God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The apostles and elders, in agreement with the whole church, decided to choose representatives and to send them to Antioch with Paul and Barnabas. The ones chosen were Judas, who is called Barsabbas, and Silas, leaders among the brothers. This is the letter delivered by them. The apostles and the elders, your brothers, to the brothers in Antioch, Syria, and Cilicia of Gentile origin, greetings. Since we have heard that some of our number, who went out without any mandate from us, have upset you with their teachings and disturbed your peace of mind, we have, with one accord, decided to choose representatives and to send them to you, along with our beloved Barnabas and Paul, who have dedicated their lives to the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. So we are sending Judas and Silas, who will also convey this same message by word of mouth. It is the decision of the Holy Spirit and of us not to place on you any burden beyond these necessities, namely to abstain from meat sacrificed to idols, from blood, from meats of strangled animals, and from unlawful marriage. If you keep free of these, you will be doing what is right. Farewell. The word of the Lord.
By his mind.
reading from the book of Revelation. The angel took me in spirit to a great high mountain and showed me the holy city of Jerusalem, coming down out of the heaven from God. It gleamed with the splendor of God. Its radiance was like that of a precious stone, like jasper, clear as crystal. It had a massive high wall with 12 gates where 12 angels were stationed and on which names were inscribed, the names of 12 tribes of the Israelites. There were 3 gates facing east, 3 north, 3 south, and 3 west. The wall of the city had 12 courses of stones as its foundation, on which were inscribed the 12 names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. I saw no temple in the city, for its temple is the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb. The city had no need of sun or moon to shine on it, for the glory of God gave it light, and its lamp was the Lamb. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
This
is a reading from the Gospel according to John. Jesus then said to his disciples, "Whoever loves me will keep my word, and my Father will love him. And we will come to him and make our dwelling with him. Whoever does not love me does not keep my words. Yet the word you hear is not mine, but that of the Father who sent me. I have told you this while I'm with you. The Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I told you. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give it to you. Do not let your hearts be troubled or afraid. You heard me tell you, I am going away, and I will come back to you. If you loved me, you would rejoice that I'm going to the Father, for the Father is greater than I. And now I have told you this before it happens, so that when it happens, you may believe." Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. I think that reading we just heard is very appropriate for this event here this evening. There was Jesus in the process of leaving his disciples, but his message to them was one of encouragement and assurance. The mood in that room that day is very much like the mood in this room today. It is a mood of some sadness, a mood of some melancholy, as well as some optimism and some gladness. It's the same there, it's the same here as it was then. At that time, Jesus said to them, and we say to you, stay with me, love me as I love you. Jesus said to them, and we say to you, I'll send you the Holy Spirit, an advocate for you, to accompany you, to teach you, to guide you, and to remind you. You will always have God with you. He said to them, and we say to you, don't be afraid. It's time for you to go. That's what it's all designed to do. He said to them, and we say to you, may peace be with you as we leave you. Our peace and our blessings we give you. My friend, Jesus Christ is always our role model. May he remain yours as you leave us. Be those men of faith and character, people of God and good choices that you have learned about here, that you have learned to be here. Gentlemen, let me ask you not to forget where you came from. I know you will never rest because together we're best. Trinity forever. Gentlemen, your senior leaders have asked one faculty member to share some impressions here this evening. Mr. Ethan Morris.
Let me tell you about the best gift that I ever received. My maternal grandfather was a carpenter, and when he died several years ago, he gifted me his most prized possession, first thing he had ever made, something he had whittled in 1938 when he was 16. He didn't give it to any of his six children. He did not give it to any of his 16 biological grandchildren. He did not give it to any of his 39 great-grandchildren. He gave it to me, the only adopted member of my family. My grandfather's gift represented the first time in my life when someone expressed how proud they were of me and how much they loved me, simply for being me. Let me be clear. I knew that people in my life were proud of me, but they were proud of me for something that I did. I received awards for my grades, praise for my college presentations, and congratulations when I got a job. Like some of you, I connected my self-worth to the things that I did. My grandfather, on the other hand, viewed things differently. As far as he was concerned, I didn't have to do anything except be myself. Today, I want to give you that same gift. You don't have to be the best student, the best brother, the best son, or the best employee, because if the rest of us are being honest, we're none of those things either. We all try to be those things, and sometimes we succeed. And it's those moments of success that we love to tell you about, sometimes a little too often. But they are moments, and moments are passing. Passing on and heading to moments when we failed, or we cruised, or maybe we didn't have too much to show for ourselves. Our failures remind us that we're not going to be the best this, that, or the other. And they redirect our focus to where it should have been the whole time. Just being ourselves. If I'm ever the best at being something, it's being me. If you're ever going to be the best at something, it's going to be being you. I am proud of each of you and what you all have done these past 4 years. I listened to many of you while you processed dating, worrying about friends and friendships, understanding people who don't act or think like you, dealing with your family's expectations, choosing a college or a major, and for some, identifying and accepting the person that you've become. I also listened to you process the pandemic. Your grandparents, parents, and teachers couldn't offer you sage advice on how to get through a pandemic. You had to figure that out yourselves, and you did so admirably. You're getting ready to graduate tomorrow, demonstrating to all of us here that you are independent, you are determined, adaptable, capable, creative, and successful. Let me say again, I am proud of you. While I'm proud of who each of you are, I want to be clear. Being yourself is a responsibility. It requires hard work, reflection, and intentionality. The term peer pressure is often associated with high school, but it's a mistake to assume that people stop trying to influence you after you graduate from high school. You'll spend the rest of your life meeting people who try, some with good intentions, some with bad, to persuade you to be more like them. There'll be people that want you to join their fraternity, switch to their major, and work at their office. You'll have people that want to date and possibly marry you. Listen to them. But remember that each decision you make takes you closer to or farther away from who you want to be. People can change you. Some of you have done things because a person or people told, asked, or suggested you to. Think about those results. For every few good memories, there's a few bad. Dwell on those bad memories for a moment. If you're not careful, you can lose yourself. The best way to avoid losing yourself is to make sure that you have a small group of friends to remind you of who you are and who you want to be. Most of you have one or two good friends, what you might call best friends. You feel completely and totally yourself around these people because you've shared everything with them. You know, they know about your mistakes and insecurities as well as your goals and the moments that you're proud of. These people will support, protect, and advise you when you're confused by career opportunities, dating, what clubs or groups to join, family expectations, and more. When you've lost sight of what you want to be, it's these close friends who will guide you back to where you belong. Don't abandon these friends, even if both of you are moving to different states this August. Remaining in contact will be difficult. It may require road trips or plane tickets, but letting them go is, in some ways, letting go of a bit of yourself. For those without best friends, or even for those with best friends, we all will spend moments of our lives alone, moments when we feel misunderstood, unheard, or unnoticed. You'll be tempted to give up. You'll wonder why you're working so hard to be you when it would be so much easier to be somebody else. Well, don't give up. Remember your senior retreat. Remember the power of saying aloud what needs to be said, even when you're saying alone in an empty room. And remember that you're never really alone. God will listen when no one else will. Being yourself and being proud of it is one of the best possible experiences any of you could ever have. Take a moment and think about what you are and what you want to be. Fix it in your mind, and when you leave here today, become what you have just envisioned. For my usual send-off, let me know if you need anything. Don't work too hard. Take it easy. And know that I'm proud of you and that I love you all very much.
Please stand now and join me in our profession of faith. And together we say, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, mountain not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the world to come. Amen. And so, dear God, we turn to you now as a people in need. So often throughout our lives, you have come to our assistance and answer to our prayer. And so we turn to you here this evening and count once again on your graciousness.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For those enduring violence, injustice, oppression, hunger, or poverty, that God's grace and mercy will bring peace, restoration, and unity. We pray to the Lord. For all those suffering consequences from the pandemic, serious illness, or injury, for the recently departed, especially members of the Trinity community, and for all those who are struggling with the loss of a loved one, that they may find healing and comfort in God's care. We pray to the Lord. For an increase in vocations to the priesthood and the religious or consecrated life, and for all of our spiritual leaders, especially our own Archbishop Shelton Faub and our Holy Father, Pope Francis, that they may be guided by the Holy Spirit in all of their endeavors. We pray to the Lord. We pray for the faculty, staff, and administration of Trinity in gratitude for all that they have given in the classroom, in their hard work, and in giving from their own hearts throughout these years. We pray to the Lord. For our parents and families who have supported us, made sacrifices, and have offered hope and love in all that they have done and will continue to do, we pray to the Lord. For the Trinity class of 2023, that they will continue to carry on the fierce pride and the legacy of Trinity and lead the underclassmen next year. We pray to the Lord. We pray for the class of 2022, that we may continue onward as a family, with our faith, into the future, always united in the brotherhood of Trinity. We pray to the Lord. For those most dear to us, and for any special intentions we hold in our hearts, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear
our prayer. Gracious God, we acknowledge your strength and your protection. Hear these prayers we offer you today, fully confident that they will be heard and heeded in your great love. We offer these things to you in the name of Jesus, your Son, who lives with you in the Holy Spirit, God, the Trinity, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. Our offertory gifts here this evening include two significant items special to us in the Trinity community. One of our seniors, Mason Christensen, will be bringing up a large leather-bound binder. Seniors, 4 years ago at your freshman academic convocation, you signed this book as a sign of your commitment to your academic studies as a student at Trinity. Tonight, it serves as a reminder that even as you move on from Trinity, this commitment to grow in knowledge and wisdom continues. The chalice we will use at this Mass, the Eucharistic cup we will use, will be carried in by Matt Gomez. It dates from 1935. It was the personal chalice of Trinity's founder, Monsignor Alfred Steinhauser. We extend our gratitude to his family for placing it in our care. It is one of our treasures. We use it only at special masses like this, at opening mass as well. We remember the legacy that Father Steinhauser started, and that you, the class of 2022, are charged with continuing that beyond these walls. And so, pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive our offerings in your mercy, O Lord, and transform them into the sacrament of redemption, the memorial of your Son's death and resurrection, so that by the power of this sacrifice and with constant trust in Christ himself, we may come to eternal life. We ask these things through that same Christ the Lord, who lives with you forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for the children, the poor, the sick, and sinners. He became a neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so, with all the angels and saints, we exalt you and bless your name and sing the hymn of your glory as without end, together we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." And then in a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for the many for the forgiveness of sins." And then he said to them, "Do this in memory of me." And so let us proclaim our faith as together we say, And so, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this bread of life and this chalice of salvation. We give you thanks that you have held us worthy to be here in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the entire world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, with Shelton, our Archbishop, and all your holy people. Remember all those brothers and sisters of ours who have already fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all those people who have died in your mercy, especially all of Trinity's own faithful departed. Welcome them all, Lord, into the light of your face. And then have mercy on all of us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the blessed apostles, with all our Trinity house patrons, St. Thomas Aquinas, St. Thomas Becket, Dante Alighieri, St. Flannan of Ireland, St. Aloysius Gonzaga, Thomas Merton, St. Patrick, St. Oscar Romero, St. Elizabeth Ann Seton, and the Venerable Pierre Toussaint, along with all those saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may be co-heirs with them to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. So united as we are with each other and with the Lord here at his table, let's not pray that prayer which Jesus himself gave us as we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from everything evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, so that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of the Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity according to your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer to each other a genuine sign of peace. Peace be with you all. Guys, feel free to move about. It is our custom here at Trinity to be as inclusive as possible at this moment, so it is our custom to invite everyone to come forward during communion, so that if you are Catholic and wish to receive the Eucharist, please put your hands out like this with palms up to receive. If you're not Catholic or do not wish to receive, simply cross your arms over your chest, and our Eucharistic minister will be happy to give you a blessing. And so, behold, this is Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those who are called here to the supper of the Lamb. So together we humbly say, Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. Temple we belong here in our hearts.
Once again, the leadership of this graduating class has selected one of their own to share some impressions here after communion at this baccalaureate mass. Tanner Blood.
Good evening. I would just like to start off by immediately thanking our class officers for choosing me to give this speech. Out of every senior in our class, you guys chose me, and that's easily the biggest honor I've ever received in my entire life. I really never thought this day would come, but here we are, the last time we'll be on campus together as students at Trinity High School. Although this may be overwhelming now, and certainly is saddening, the future of our class is beyond bright. What a ride it has truly been. Everyone says when you come to school here to soak it all in because the time will really fly by. And I just remember thinking, yeah, right. But the time, it really did fly by. Do you guys remember our freshman academic convocation where we came here and signed the papers right over here? It was actually in that book that Mason brought up, all those papers. That really feels like yesterday. Looking back 4 short years ago, there's absolutely no way I could have gotten up on this stage in front of all of you all and given this speech. I was a truly short, shy, and reserved kid. But over the last 4 years, I've grown into myself. Literally. I was 5'1" sophomore year. I actually took a communication skills class sophomore year, and I was horrible at giving speeches. So I'd just like to quickly shout out Ms. Zucchero for helping me gain more confidence and take some leaps of faith, which has led me to accomplishing things that I never thought I would be capable of. The class of 2022 has faced so much adversity in our 4 years, and yet here we are at our baccalaureate mass. The brotherhood here at Trinity is truly like no other, and I feel so incredibly blessed to have been a part of something so special. However, none of us could have made it this far without the support of everyone here around us in the bleachers. So on behalf of the class of 2022, to everyone here, thank you so much for giving us the opportunity to come to this amazing school. And to the parents and or family members that are watching down on us from heaven, thank you for being our guardian angels. Coming into Trinity, I'd really set 3 main goals for myself. Try and figure out what I want to do in life, get a great education, and meet some new friends. And I'd like to talk about each one of those points briefly. First, discovering what I wanted to do with my life. Mr. Harris, over there controlling the camera, I owe you so much. You have been an amazing leader for me throughout my 4 years here. The amazing thing about Mr. Harris is he was a full-time teacher throughout the day and then would go home, and he was also a full-time student. He just completed grad school this spring. Mr. Harris, you have no idea how much your guidance helped me through my 4 years. And that guidance played a huge role in me deciding that I want to pursue a career in broadcasting. The opportunities I have had here at Trinity, like anchoring and directing Trinity Television, broadcasting for Mr. Subcheck's esports program, and creating news stories outside of the classroom, have truly given me a platform, and those experiences will go a long way for me as I start my next chapter. So that was goal number one, figure out what I wanted to do with life. As for goal number two, when it comes to getting a great education, it does not get any better than this school. And it all starts with the amazing faculty and staff that we have here. I truly believe this school has the best teachers in the world. And I would argue that it was probably the hardest that you'll have ever had to work given the pandemic. I read on NBC News that 55% of public school teachers wanted to exit the profession because they were so burnt out from the pandemic. The United States lost 567,000 teachers. We know just how hard it was for you all to keep pushing and provide us the best possible education. And I'm here to tell you, on behalf of our class, that each and every single one of you all did an amazing job, and you will truly never know the impact that you have had on us as a class. Miss Wagner, your kindness and constant smile brought so much joy to us as a class. Mr. Bowles, I know so many guys that have developed friendships with you that are going to stretch outside of the classroom now that we're graduating from here. You are truly an amazing human, and good luck playing golf against some of my classmates. Mr. Morris, I never actually had you in class, But as a student, you hear from your friends and classmates, you know, around the building about teachers that have maybe an annoying assignment or quiz or homework or whatever it may be. But every time your name was brought up, it was always something positive. Always. Never heard anything negative. And that shows the impact you had on us as a class. Coach Norman, you are one of the most positive people that I've ever met. Your connection to each of your students is truly remarkable. And I wish I could have formed a relationship with you before senior year, because your knowledge on things in life is truly amazing. Thank you for always being so personable and willing to talk. And finally, Mr. Baldwin, wow, I don't even know where to start with this one. You are easily the most unique teacher that I have ever had, and I mean that in the absolute best possible way. You told us on the first day of class the reason you keep coming back to teach is because we keep you young. And I totally get that now. Because you adapted to us as a class, you gave us so many memorable quotes, you joined in on our jokes. I honestly had so many laughs in your class, and that truly made learning fun. And teachers like you are the reason why paying for a premium education from Trinity is worth it. And Trinity is truly lucky to have you on their staff. Now, I could stand here and continue to talk about so many teachers, but unfortunately, I do not have the time. But once again, thank you so much to every single teacher, faculty member, administrator, flick worker, and everyone who came together to give us the best possible experience here at Trinity. You are all amazing. And finally, my last goal, to meet some new friends. To the class of 2022, my brothers, that goal was blown out of the water. My biggest takeaway from this school will be the relationships that I've made. I've bonded with so many of you over the last couple of years, and I cannot wait to see where these friendships go in life. Today is the last day we're on campus together as students. Tomorrow we will walk across that stage, and when that day is over, we will all go our separate ways. The amazing thing is, no matter what path that may be, whether you're going all the way to Malibu, California, like Logan Bull, who will be attending Pepperdine University, or like Aryan Patel, who will be going down south to South Florida University, or maybe you're even like Owen Cronin, who will be headed north to go to Michigan State, or maybe you're hitting the East Coast, like Devin Williams, who is headed to Coastal Carolina. No matter where you're going next year, or whatever your plan may be post-graduation, it doesn't matter because we will always, always be connected as a class. Just think about it for a second, what we've done as a class. 2 cross-country state championships. 2 football state championships. We beat St. X in volleyball not once but twice this year, and that was the first time we beat them in 9 years. Not to mention, the second win came in the state championship, which that is the first state championship in volleyball since 2013. Also, our class was a major, and I mean major factor, in the first ever baseball state title in school history. Corbin Dickerson is actually a nominee for the Gatorade Player of the Year in the state of Kentucky. But congratulations to all the baseball players. You will forever be a part of history here at Trinity. 2 students scored perfect on the ACT in Matthew Chow and Bucky Abood Hall. Our class, we should be proud of our class officers, especially Graven. You are an outstanding president. And I know you heard a lot of jokes this year about you being the president or whatever, but I'm here to tell you in front of everybody that you did a fantastic job. And we could not have asked for a better president. We couldn't have asked for a better person, a better leader, a better young man. I could go on and on. Graven, you did a fantastic job. Our class had 8 students get recognized by the National Merit Scholarship Corporation, which, in case you didn't know, is exceptional. And those 8 are Matthew Chow, Ryan Groza, Luke MacArthur, Paul Springer, Garrett Weekly, Ethan Brunton, Bucky Abood Hall, and Aiden Workman. Congrats to everybody, everybody. Like, seriously, that's awesome. As a class, we were accepted into a school record-breaking 174 colleges and universities across the country. And this year, a student was accepted into an Ivy League school. That's the first Trinity student since 2018 to get accepted into an Ivy school. So special shout out to Ryan Groza, who will actually be attending the University of Pennsylvania. This class has been truly special. But one of our biggest accomplishments, if not the biggest, has to be the fact we were the first senior class to be back in the building full-time all year. We were tasked with bringing back that feeling of being a student at Trinity. The freshmen and sophomores were all basically freshmen this year due to COVID, and the juniors had never completed a full year here at Trinity. And I've heard from many teachers that we did an outstanding job. They could truly feel the unity back in the hallways. The passion was there, and it filled the halls. The tradition was brought back, and it truly shows how being together at school is truly what's best. But that's it. Our time here is done. I could not have asked for a better group of guys to experience high school with. And as Vince Lombardi said, the greatest accomplishment is not in never falling, but rising again after you fall. You will have failures along the way, but remember, mindset is everything. Nothing can stop you. If you take away something from every failure, you will never lose. But if I'm being honest, you will hear plenty of inspiring speeches and words of encouragement throughout your life. You probably already have. But what it all comes down to is be you and do what you love, and success and happiness are naturally going to follow. Always follow your dreams, and certainly never give up. And I cannot wait to see what we all accomplish in life. From the bottom of my heart, thank you to each and every single one of you. Live the Fourth, Trinity forever.
Great, I get to follow that. Tanner, I can see why you were asked not to lead just one, but two senior retreats. Great job. Welcome. These remarks will be short. I am Rob Mullen. I'm the president of this school. I'm a graduate of Trinity from 45 years ago. Welcome to this wonderful celebration. I have three quick messages, but a preface. First, I want to welcome grandparents. We mentioned parents a lot this weekend. I want to extend a big welcome to grandparents and even great-grandparents who are here. Being a six-time grandparent myself, you need to some special attention, don't you? You've provided wonderful support, maybe even financially. This might be the first time some of you all have been on our campus, so now you see where your loved one has been. And I know what you're thinking, since I'm a grandparent. You're looking down here upon your grandson and proud of his achievements and thinking about all the places he's come from and where he is now. And you're thinking, all that he's achieved, he got from my side of the family. If you allow me, I want to extend a special greeting to one of these students' grandfather who is not here. And you guys might not even have known it, but every time you walked into the Library Media Center, you entered into the W. Peter Flagg Library Media Center. It's named after Luke Brodsky's grandfather. His wife, Marty, and daughter, Christy, are here. Where are you? Can you give us a wave, Marty and Christy? Some of us who work here remember Peter. He was our first principal who was not a priest, so the first layman to ever be a principal at Trinity. And then he became our first president. Died way too young, but left an incredible impression, fingerprints all over what we enjoy here today at Trinity, and meant an incredible amount to me personally and professionally. And I know this weekend, Pete would have been extremely proud to see Luke graduate from his school. Welcome also to all of you extended family members. We have it here in this gym versus a parish because we can get more of you all here, even though it might be a little bit uncomfortable in the bleachers. Parents, your relationship with your son is changing. I remember for many of you all, this is your oldest, and you've got him through high school. It ain't gonna get any easier, I can tell you that. And I know that you're wrapped up with all kinds of emotions. I recall the weekend we took our oldest daughter to school. It was a move-in weekend, lots of things. The kids were off doing something. Parents were meeting in dorms, and there was this wise old nun who was talking to us parents. And she said, well, how many of you parents, is this your oldest child going to college? And my wife and I, along with others, feebly raised our hands emotionally and wrapped up with all that we were giving up and wondering about. And then she said, well, how many of you all, is this your last child going to college? And all these parents jotted their hand up in the air and they cheered. I thought, what's wrong with you people? Whether he stays in town or leaves for school, stays in town for a job or school, your relationship is changing. It's not less important, but it's going to be different. It's going to be different. So blessings to you on that great journey. At the end of Mass, it looks like it stopped raining. If you can linger a little bit, we'll move across the entryway over to the Hollenbach Family Alumni Courtyard. Join us just for a little bit of extended time. There are three parts to my remarks, some thanks, quick comments about graduation, and then a message to the seniors. First, it is so good to be able to have this Mass, first that we've had for graduation weekend since 2019, and it has just been really good despite the little downpour. And these things don't happen just by accident, so a few people to thank, Mr. Hogue and the operations crew who get this stuff set up, to our campus ministers, Ms. Emmerich and Mr. Lucan, to all of the singers and musicians, it was beautiful tonight, to the sound engineers, to the greeters, the readers, the gift bearers, Eucharistic ministers, Mr. Morris for his words. Had a college professor say to me one time, all of us education majors said, Let's talk about why you want to be a teacher. And I'm thinking, well, we want to change the world and all that sort of thing. And she eventually said, no, you just like to hear yourself talk. Well, it was really nice yesterday morning. The senior leaders surprised Mr. Morris and made him an honorary member of the class of 2022. And he did not know about it. And he got up on the podium and he stuttered and stumbled and eventually said, I'm speechless. All I can say is, I love you. That's all you needed to say. And Tanner, again, that was powerful. Thank you for that energy. How about a round of applause for all those who helped bring this together? This Mass is such an important part of graduation weekend, this Baccalaureate Mass. It underlines one of our efforts that's a part of our mission, and that is to work on forming these students as men of faith. And that's an active verb. We don't say by the time you finish here, you will have become a man of faith. It's a lifelong journey, and this Mass helps underline that. Second, some remarks about graduation. We do it really, really well if you've ever been to one of ours before. At Bellarmine, it's air conditioned. Last year we had to go outside. We had 6 medical emergencies. I'm glad we're indoors. I was there today. They got a noisy air conditioner, but it's cool. There's also lots of good seats wherever you end up being, in the stands or on the floor. Plenty of convenient parking. There'll be some seats reserved. Just stay away from those if you would. One of the really neat things, and let's really hope that it's dry around, you know, between 9:30 and 10:30 tomorrow, because one of the really neat traditions that's grown up over the decades is presenting each graduate a boutonniere, and oftentimes a family member will pin that on. So hopefully it'll be dry. You can be out there in front of Bellarmine and have that take place. The ceremony will last about 90 minutes. There are 2 special honorees. We give out 2 important awards. You'll hear tomorrow who they are, what it's about, and why we do it. They give very, very short remarks, like 3 minutes, okay? One is Dr. Benny Clausing. He's getting the Trinity Peace Medal. And the other, Miss Annette Manley Turner, she's getting the Peace Medal. Dr. Clausing is getting the Honor Alumnus. You'll hear tomorrow, they are our last lessons. It's going to be live streamed by Trinity like this is on our website. But we have a request. Don't know how often you've been to some graduations lately, high school or college. Yelling out catcalls, noisemakers, when a graduate's name is announced. It's not the way we do it. Graduation underlines another part of our mission, this idea of helping these guys get to the point where they can go into life with some further studying. So this underlines our academic mission. Most of the time tomorrow is given to giving each of these graduates their moment in the spotlight. So if you or someone in your party yells for one of these guys as he walks across the stage, it does two things. It embarrasses him, and it takes away attention to the next guy. So please, show up, smile, wait till they're all across the stage, and then we'll holler till our hearts are content. Can we agree to that, please? I got to tell you this anecdote. I was walking through the cafeteria on an exam day. There were about 8 seniors hanging around. And I walked up to them. They let me intrude into their group. And I said, "Hi guys, how's it going? What are you doing after exams?" One guy said, "Well, I'm going to lunch." Another guy said, "I think he means after we graduate." He said, oh. And it was so cool. My question wasn't very clear, but okay. It was so cool what I heard from those 8 guys. It summed up perfectly who we try to be. There were some headed to college, locally, New Mexico. There were some who had already had plans to go directly into the workforce. There was one of them who said, "I've got this particular career, I'm going to start with my dad." One said, "I don't know if it'll happen, but I'd love to go to Italy and study under this world-renowned pastry chef." So these guys with different backgrounds and interests and goals, every one of them, though, had kind of their chest puffed out and their shoulders back like, "I'm going." That was a really neat reminder for me of what we try to do. So, help us celebrate them with the proper decorum on Sunday. Thank you. Last part, you seniors. I defer to others to do most of my talking. So, why have you captured just a couple thoughts? I really like what Dr. Zoller said yesterday morning. Now, did you notice the kind of little rumble that was going through the room when he was talking about some reality? It was really depressing. We'll reprint it in the next leader this summer. Don't stop halfway through, okay? Get to the end. He had some great remarks for you. If you listened through the whole thing, what he was telling you is, based upon what these people have started you with and what you picked up here, you have the power to take the path that is smart and healthy. There's a reality. There is ugliness out there. But you have the tools to take the right path. I hope this weekend, somewhere along the way, with all the pats on the back you're getting and all that sort of thing, I hope somewhere along the way, you sincerely, in looking in their eyes, thank the people who got you to this point in life. It's already been mentioned that freshman class academic convocation. You had no clue what we were doing. You had barely figured out where English class was. We haul you over here on a Thursday night and do this academic convocation. I don't know if you remember how the room was set up. You were facing that way, and we had a stage over there. Teachers were on either side of you. Parents were in the stands. There were some symbols of academic departments brought up. A senior spoke to you. Dr. Zoller spoke to you. You signed that commitment. And we said that night we had the room set up that way for a reason. Teachers were up front symbolically to say, we'll lead you through the next 4 years. Come this way. And we said your parents were sitting behind you to symbolize having your back for those moments when you needed a little bit of pushing, like, go ahead and try that. And those moments when that gentle push may have been a shove, like, get in your room and do your homework. And sometimes they were behind you with a swift kick in your rear end because you needed that too. So that night, you were facing that way, teachers saying, follow us, them supporting you. Well, look how we are sitting now. They're surrounding you. Sort of now going to be walking along with you. They're going to be walking along with you. I hope one of them isn't like the mom who admitted to me that one day she drove up to UK, parked outside her son's dorm room, called him and said, hey, do you want to go to lunch? He said, Mom, no, I got class at 1 o'clock. You can't get up here that soon. She said, well, I'm already here. And he lifted up the blind of his dorm room and said, get out of here, Mom, what are you doing? None of them will do that. They're going to be walking along with you, okay? And then look where your teachers are. They're not up here saying, come this way. They're behind you saying, you're ready. And what's in front of you? Well, this altar, that's a good thing to have in front of you for the rest of your life. And then also, your future's in front of you. Not that wall, okay? I'm talking about the rest of the world, okay? As you gather in Alumni Courtyard or as you leave, notice something for me if you would. When we redid that courtyard a few years ago, we added some arches. Harvard is kind of known for having a lot of arch gateways on their campus, so we kind of borrowed that idea. We added three arches to that courtyard. And there's a stone in the middle of each of them. And we had a chance to put on that stone what we wanted. I don't know if you've ever noticed, but if you enter from Shelbyville Road onto campus, there's a word on each of those three arches. Maximo, Animi, Ardore. We who come to work here, and you who came to study here, that's what we've been called to do. That Latin phrase Monsignor Steinhauser came up with that said, with the maximum effort of your soul, or give it all you got. That's what we've asked you to do. And you may not have reached that every single day, but I know that you've strived for that. As you're out there, look at the arches from this side. As we were thinking about what to put on those keystones, it was Mr. Jackson who suggested a great idea, so we did it. And the center stone is our crest. On the left-hand side, it says Trinity. And the far right-hand side, it says forever. We're hoping that after this experience, that phrase, Trinity forever, is embedded in your heart and you carry it forward. I call Dr. Zoller up to lead us in a blessing over you.
I would invite all our faculty members to stand, please, and for them to extend their hands and join in this blessing over the class of 2022. Gentlemen, before you were even formed, God knew you. While in your mother's womb, God named you. At your birth, God's breath filled you with life. Today, we celebrate what you have become at this moment in time, and so we pray.
God of our beginnings, we thank you for the gift of these graduates as they step forward into the world that awaits. Here's with the full knowledge of your divine presence. Guide their feet as they move through life.
Protect them from the pitfalls of darkness.
Help them to lead future generations
into the warmth and promise of your light.
We ask this blessing upon each one of them.
In the name, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
One God, the Trinity, now and forever. Amen.
Before we conclude, let me just give you a couple of instructions about what we're going to do as we leave. In a moment, we'll sing the Alma Mater together and have our final blessing. After that blessing and our final song, Graven and I will lead out this way and go out to the Hollenbach Alumni Courtyard, and seniors, you can follow that after the faculty. You can linger and visit out there or in here, and maybe pose for some pictures and so forth. Thank you all for being here this evening. Everyone, please stand now and join us in the Alma Mater.
And shout her name wherever you may be. May our love be known to all our love for Trinity. Loyal to the green and white, we stand united here. Faithful to dear Trinity through each succeeding year. Raise your voice and shout her name wherever you may be. May our love be known to all our love for Trinity.
The Lord be with you all. Let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. May Almighty God keep adversity far from you, order your days in peace, and pour out upon you the gifts of his blessing. Amen. May God keep your hearts attentive to his word and make you persevere in holy deeds so that you may be filled with everlasting gladness. Amen. May you be effective in good works, rich in gifts of hope, faith, and charity, and may be made co-heirs with the citizens of heaven. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God. Let's make an aisle there for part. Yeah.
Father, Spirit, bringing us light, uniting the Father.